Welcome back to The Witcher 3. We're doing this sort of murder mystery quest where we're trying to figure out who is it that almost killed Priscilla, and who definitely killed many other people. Of course, I think I know who it is, the Eternal Fire guy that we saw just a while ago. But apparently there's been a new victim and the coroner wants our help. So let's go see what's going on.
Geralt, right? I'm glad you're here. Held off on the autopsy till you arrived.
Nice of you, especially given you didn't seem pleased about my previous visit.
Because you came unannounced and in unfortunate company. I also had Reverend Nathaniel to contend with. Our spiritual caretaker has left the city on some important matter. And I know who you are, what drives you. I'm more than happy to aid your investigation.
I'm a bit suspicious about this guy. I'm very suspicious about him. Although if he doesn't get along with Nathaniel, that's actually a good thing. Because I'm pretty sure it's Nathaniel who's the murderer.
Not fond of Nathaniel?
Very few people are. He's cruel and capricious. He stormed in here once, grabbed a scalpel I was sterilizing over a burner, sliced my back with it to the bone.
Jesus.
Because I had forgotten to lock the storeroom. Hard to be fond of someone like that, wouldn't you agree?
What the fuck kind of a thing is that to do?
Who's the victim this time?
Joris Aquinas. A lecturer in theology at Oxenfurt Academy. Found this morning at his home on a catafalque made of his books.
Any titles in particular?
It seems all the tomes dealt with the eternal fire. Treatise critical of the faith's doctrines.
Oh, it's definitely
yeah.
Nathaniel.
Mortal sin in Novigrad.
Nathaniel is definitely the killer.
By the way, you and von Gratz don't exactly get along. Why is that?
I had him sent to prison. You see, Joachim led the student protests in 1242, a senseless and brutal revolt. People were dying, Witcher. Those who rejected liberty, equality, and fraternity would be found in the gutter come morning. Their throats slit from ear to ear with surgical precision. Joachim had been my favorite student, but alas, I had to do something. So I reported him. Then I left the university and found work in the morgue, where none care about my past. Whereas Joachim, oh, fate's ironies. Years later, he was appointed head of the very ward I had founded.
Look a little young to be von Gratz's teacher. Indeed, I was just thinking that. I was actually thinking that before when we first met him. He seems really young. And I thought it was like 20 years ago or something that he taught Joachim the trade. Which means he must be, what, like 50 years old now? He does not look 50.
How old's von Gratz? 50? 60?
53, I believe. Why do you ask?
You look a little young to have been his teacher.
Not surprising. For years I've lived in the cold and dark, breathing the vapors of embalming fluids. In short, working with corpses extends one's life. Amusing, is it not?
That is ironic.
Let's start.
Gladly. The wounds conform to the killer's modus operandi. The victim was bound and forced to drink formaldehyde. Next, the killer removed the eyes, placed burning coals in the sockets, then opened the rib cage and... What's this? A parchment made of human skin.
A message from the murderer, the name of his next victim. Patricia Vagelbud.
Do you know her?
Oh,
yes.
God.
Even went to her estate once with... Gotta find her, now.
Mm-hmm. I'm actually a little bit suspicious of Hubert here. Specifically, I'm suspicious that he might be the killer. Perhaps... I don't know, it almost seems as if Nathaniel is too easy of a target. What if Hubert knows Nathaniel and is doing the murders as if they were done by Nathaniel, thereby making him the suspect? knowing that it'd be easy to pin it on somebody who's so horrible. With such a past of being a torturer and just a terrible person. I don't know. That seems extreme, though. That's really extreme. But I'm just thinking about a potential twist.
Till next time.
Alright, let's find that nearest fast travel place. Oh god, Nathaniel said he had to leave on urgent business or something, right? The urgent business might be traveling to the Vegelbud residence? Oh boy. I need to get there now.
Now you.
Hopefully I can catch him in the act, before he's actually done anything.
What do you want?
Need to talk to Patricia Vagelbud.
You think any bum off the street can...
Her life's in danger. Let me in or have her blood on your hands.
If you thought this up, and I let you in, we'll throw my arse out the door.
Always thought a guard was supposed to protect his charge, not his ass.
So be it. I'll take you to Lady Vagelbud. Just no trickery. Understand?
Okay, she's still alive. Good. Good.
Oh, Geralt, what a pleasant surprise.
Not pleasant at all. I gotta see your mother. Her life's in danger.
Oh, it's not actually her.
Come on. I saw mother this morning. She seemed sad, true, but in perfect health.
No time to explain. Let's go.
No time to explain. Trust me, please.
I find this all very hard to believe, but you appear to be quite serious. Please, follow me.
A fire fit for Beltane, except it's the wrong time of year.
I mentioned Mother seemed sad. Do you remember? In fact, she's in the midst of a crisis of faith. A rather serious one. We'd been to Novigrad. Mother had seen the pyres in Hierarch Square, uttered not a word on our way home. She had all the holy books, insignias, reliquaries gathered, taken outside and burnt. Then she locked herself in her room.
We need to hurry.
Yeah, let's, like, sprint.
Hear that? Calm and quiet. All seems to be in order.
Or she's dead.
I should go in, just to be sure.
You're relentless, aren't you? Fine. But wait here, please. Mother's certainly not in the mood for guests.
He ran out the other door! Catch him!
I think her mother might have been dead already. I'm not sure what I saw. I'm not gonna kill these dogs.
Spread out! Murderer's still here! There he is! Get him!
I'm not the freaking murderer, come on. Where the hell do I go now? Do I have to defeat these guards? Shit.
I'll break your bones!
I guess I have to defeat them. Alright.
Son of a...
What's happening? There we go.
Halt! Or I'll put a bolt between your eyes!
Listen, you got the wrong guy.
Save your trickery! Taking you to the heiress!
Well, killer's already escaped. Lead the way, hero.
We got him, Lady Ingrid. Wasn't easy, but...
Lower that crossbow before you hurt yourself. This man is innocent.
Forgive me. I saw him running. Thought it was the killer fleeing.
I was chasing him, and I'd have caught him if you hadn't gotten in my way.
Out of my sight, at once! Mother, why did he do this to her? Why?
So she is dead then?
Because she blasphemed the eternal fire, only thing that ties her to the other victims. Ingrid, I know this is a hard time for you, but usually the killer leaves a note on the body, a note indicating his next victim. May I?
Very well. But you should be on your own. I do not wish to see her in this state. I do not wish to remember her like that. And let her be the last victim. Please.
Did he do everything?
Bruises, broken fingernails. She defended herself. Must be why it took him longer, and why he almost got caught. Here it is. Sweet Nettie, crippled Cates. Growing bolder, not just the name, but the place too. Won't get away this time.
Why are they leaving the name of their next victim? And the name and the place, why? Is it like a dare? Catch me if you can, see if you can keep up with me?
Same wounds as the previous victims. Examination would be a waste of time. Gotta get to crippled Cates, fast. Another empty formaldehyde bottle. Same wounds as the previous victims.
Loop. There we go.
Examination would be a waste of time.
Another sermon.
Gotta get to crippled Cates, fast. Same wounds as the previous victims. Examination would be a waste of time. Gotta get to crippled Cates, fast.
Yes, thank you, Geralt. I got the idea. Alright, let's go. Should I even bother reading the note from a concerned citizen?
White head like a miller's son.
I guess I'll take a quick look at it. Let's see. Remember, good people, that the fire devours everything in its path, sparing no one and stopping for nothing. The fire burns all sinners alike, be they paupers or princes, men or non-humans, weak or powerful. Whoever breaks its commandments, whoever does not heed the church's counsel, whoever worships false gods, the same shall be turned to ash in its flame. Live then in the truth of the eternal fire, listen to its holy men, for they are your shepherd. Well, I think we can pretty safely rule out the coroner, because there's no way he got from where I was before all the way over to the Vigelblood residence and did that before I even got there. There's no way. Then again, it does seem like they jumped over a 15-foot high wall.
Careful, you scamp. This is no regret.
Have mercy! Wait!
Come on, I better get there in time this time. I'm sick of finding just bodies after the fact. What's the front door? Is the front door? No.
Sweet Nettie, where is she?
Upstairs. But she's with a very important client. Do not disturb them.
The client, huh? Okay, yeah, we need to go fast.
I'll give you a disturbance. You normally fight for that. Madam, pray brave lads from the guard already.
Up more, 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 more. Out of my way, out of my way.
Darn it to heck!
Is the material world? Maybe they'll draw to you.
Shit.
No one will hear you, bitch. Not a soul.
You, though? Whole town will hear you in a minute.
Yet again you disturb me. And I so dislike being disturbed.
What a surprise,
I'm
Nathaniel.
I'm to play with sweet Nettie, render her not so sweet, but I shall see to you first.
What, no foreplay? No formaldehyde? Coals in my eye sockets?
What the fuck are you on about?
Murder. You killed Fabian Meyer, Patricia Vagelbud, and many others.
Bollocks. You're mistaken, vagrant.
What? Is there something more going on here? What's going on here?
Found a message on Patricia's body. Led me here to crippled Kate's. To sweet Nettie. If you didn't leave it, who did?
I don't know. But I see we must talk. Calmly.
Who knew you'd be here?
Strangely enough, I don't announce these outings far and wide. There's but one man who... That's impossible. He treats even corpses with kid gloves.
The coroner. Said you were busy, that you wouldn't visit the morgue. Gotta go after him.
Go. To warehouse 12 at the docks. He's there this time of day procuring supplies. Formaldehyde. I shall stay here. I've unfinished business with sweet Nettie.
Oh, really?
After all,
you're gonna stay here?
I paid in advance.
You think I'm just gonna just leave you here, huh? No.
Then you'll pay again. For her, for all the other women you've tortured.
Fuck you, Nathaniel.
You're free now.
Oh, thank you. Thank you. If not for you. He asked if I did everything, and I said, for the right price, of course. And then he smiled. Oh, God, it gave me the shivers. And then he hit me so hard I passed out. I was bound when I came to. And he was here in the poker, in the fire.
Calm down. He won't hurt you anymore. He won't hurt anyone.
She's burned really bad. Get his poker weapon. Great. I wouldn't even dare use it just because of how sick it is, but I'm curious what the stats are. It's actually not too bad. Very plain, but the damage is pretty good. But definitely not better than what I have. And even if it was, I would not wear it. Oh my god. Okay, I'm just gonna stop sprinting. Doesn't seem to be very productive.
We can go at it here, or at my place.
Rubbish. It's a material world.
If I thought Nathaniel was sick, I guess this guy's gonna be about 10 times sicker.
Butters won't hassle you, Richard. Your average non-human doctor.
You know, I should probably repair my weapon. I think I should repair my weapons. 41%, 74%. It's something I've been neglecting for pretty much the entire game. Let's do it. Where are my kits? Is it alchemy and crafting? Is it under equipment? Yeah, there we go. Armor, weapon, 15% restored. Yeah, I'll use these. Let's put one on this one too. There we go, 89%, 86%. Knock knock!
Run out of formaldehyde. I underestimated you. You almost caught me in flagrante delicto. Now you've seen through my bluff with Nathaniel. Although, you've not divined all, I see.
Oh, it is him!
Had you would have drawn your silver sword.
Who, what are you?
A vampire. Hire, of course.
That's why you're so young. I dismissed that as like, oh, that's kind of funny, formaldehyde and being around preservation and corpses and stuff, that made him look young, but no. I thought maybe there's something going on with that, but I kind of dismissed it. Put it to the back of my mind. That does explain it.
Got a reason for killing? A reason to torture?
I thought you'd figure that out as well. The symbolism's rather obvious. Coals for those who are blind to the fire. The egg of a salamander born of fire to replace their cold, doubting hearts. Fire down the throat that...
Yeah, symbolism's clear. What's not is why a vampire would kill in the name of the eternal fire.
Should be equally obvious. I concur with the church's diagnosis. Novigrad is a fallen city. Its population amnesiacs to the very concepts of decency and morality. So I decided to remind them, in a manner they'd be certain to notice.
Wow, they don't get decency and morality, so he pours formaldehyde down their throat, gouges out their eyes, puts burning coals in there, cuts out their hearts, puts salamander eggs inside of them. That's his idea of decency and morality.
Tortured logic.
Yet logic, nonetheless. I'm glad you perceived that, at least. Fight fire with fire, as they say. Give a thought to my victims. A lecherous woodcarver who'd spend his last copper on whores. An old countess who defiled symbols of the faith. A Trebiritz for whom nothing was sacred, nothing above ridicule. They did not deserve to live. But their deaths could be a lesson to others. Awaken them, scare them onto the correct path, the path to the fire, to cleansing, to salvation. For you, I'm afraid it's too late. You are a man of little faith. I sense this.
But I'm pretty good with a sword.
Pretty good.
Oh boy. This might be a really hard fight. Do I have vampire oil? I keep forgetting it, but I'm pretty sure I don't. Vampires are just vampires, not cursed ones, right? Yeah, they're just vampires. And you are a higher vampire. And I do not have vampire oil. This music is really cool. This whole questline has been just really one of the best in the game so far. It's just really fascinating and intriguing, and it just really kept me hooked. It's also been one of the most disturbing questlines. Probably only topped by the Bloody Baron's questline, but yeah, this is kind of awesome. Disturbing, but really neat. Oh, fuck. Come on. Bring it on. Fancy footwork. Holy shit, you have a lot of health. This is such a cool fight. I love it. It's a test of my dodging abilities. Just gotta be patient. Gotcha. Assassin's boots. Oh, I'm getting a bunch of items. Somehow. I don't know where I got the items from, but I'll take them. See if anything else pops up. Nope, that's it. Alright. Oh. Relic weapon. Let's take a look at that weapon. Level 16. Nice. So base damage is considerably more. I think it's a better weapon. The only thing I don't like about it is it doesn't have the chance to freeze, and it doesn't have the plus 15 frost damage. All it does is increase your like sign intensities, which I really don't care about that much. But I think it's just a better weapon. Because it does more damage, it has the same number of slots. Yeah, I'm gonna use it. Cool. Also, I think it might be time to do some alchemy and see if we can craft the vampire oil. Because I've been missing the vampire oil for a long time. So let's see if we can do it. It's been a while since I've taken a look in here. Superior beast oil. Let's go ahead and make that. Although that is going to use my rubido, which I feel like I needed that for other stuff. Let's see what we're missing for vampire oil. Maybe it's just the recipe? Maybe I just don't have the recipe. I don't, do I? I don't even have the recipe. Alright, well in that case, let's make this. Anything else? Already have, already have, already have, already have every single potion. Yeah, it looks like that's it. I do need to start making some more oils, though. Mine are kind of out of date. Like, what am I missing here? Cockatrice stomach? Draconid oil? Oh, I don't even have basic draconid oil. Looks like I'm missing a lot of recipes more than anything. This, I'm just missing eye and bear fat. That's right, bear fat was one of the big things I needed. Back to Dandelion. I really hope Priscilla is going to be able to sing again sometime. I mean, she's very good at playing instruments, so she at least still has that, but her voice was also so beautiful. And if that's gone, that's going to be... That's such a big part of her life, just ruined.
Never let your kind in, Novigrad proper.
Oh no.
How's
better? Right?
Yes.
Did you take care of what I asked?
Yeah. The Witcher's way.
Thank you, Geralt. From me and Priscilla.
Don't mention it. Nothing a friend wouldn't do. She's talking again. Nice surprise.
Isn't it? Professor Von Gratz told me her wounds are healing faster than a troll's. Not the most flattering comparison, but encouraging. Maybe she might even sing again someday. For now, we'll try performing as a duo. She'll play the lute, I'll sing. Dandelion and Calinetta. Got a nice ring to it, doesn't it?
Sounds great. Good luck, Dandelion. On stage and off.
I feel so empty now that quest is finished. It was so long and involved and interesting. I wonder if I can tell Von Gratz about his teacher.
Yes, Geralt?
I'm guessing he didn't know. Oh, I can ask him about Shani. Haven't seen her in a long time.
Know another surgeon from Oxenford Academy. Her name's Shani. Know her? Red hair, cropped short, freckles.
And a hopeless idealist. Naturally, I know her. She was my assistant for a year.
Any idea where she is now?
My gut tells me she's somewhere along the front, patching up pikemen. I told her it would be futile. In the time she saved 100 lives, another 1,000 would be lost. But medics with a mission, you can't argue with them.
Found and killed the murderer. It was Hubert. You were right not to trust him. He was a higher vampire.
I thought nothing could surprise me in Novigrad. Seems I was wrong. Deeply wrong. Thank you, Geralt. Were it not for you, this would never have ceased.
He doesn't seem terribly surprised or distraught about the news. I mean, he said he was surprised, but I was expecting a stronger reaction.
Hubert told me about your past, even more vivid than I'd assumed.
I've not time for riddles, Geralt. Be straight or be gone.
Any truth to his claim that people died during the riots at the university? Died for your cause?
I was young and stupid. I thought a better future was worth any price. Even a human life or two. But those are past sins. Sins I've atoned for.
Why is the university in Oxenford closed?
Because it suits Radovid. You've not heard the story? The rector wished to grant him an honorary doctorate. The faculty disagreed. Nonetheless, Radovid arrived for the ceremony, donned a gown, collected his diploma, and when it was over, imprisoned the deans and the entire academic senate so they wouldn't raise a stink. I've been at Vilmerius Hospital ever since. But perhaps it's for the best. I'm far more adept scalpel in hand than I ever was behind a lectern.
Oh, Radovid.
Farewell.
I really do need to help Dijkstra remove him from Bauer. Alright, you know what I want to do now? I want to... Actually, before I do the thing I want to do, I want to sell a bunch of my gear. Because I think my weight... Yeah, I've got 129 pounds out of 130. So I need to dump some of my stuff. I'm going to do that, and I'll be right back. Alright, so I sold a bunch of my garbage, which has freed up a ton of weight, as you can see. 68 out of 130. I also bought something that is really, really nice. Check this out. Zerikanian saddlebags. My current saddlebags give me 70 maximum inventory weight. This gives me 100. So 30 more. Now I can hold 160. I am very happy. Now, I was going to go do the main thing that I wanted to do, but along the way, I just found this exclamation mark person, so let's see what they want.
Alright, what have you got there?
Magic accessories, alchemy ingredients, potions, and much more.
Interesting. Don't look a bit like a mage.
True. Perhaps because I'm not a mage. I just take care of the sundries the poor folk who burn at the stake leave behind. Ensure they end up in the right hands.
Fine. What do you have?
Naught but rarities at unbeatable Oh shit, you didn't see me here.
Witch hunters? Yep.
The halfling. What did he want? And why did he bolt when he saw us coming?
I'm not gonna give him up.
Left his soup on the burner.
I've half a mind to put you on the burner, wise ass. Got my eye on you. Let's go!
Then we'll come for you, don't you worry.
Oh, I can track him down.
Quite the brew. Halfling wasn't lying. Scent's gotta be carrying quite a ways.
I'm sick. Sick of it all.
Another concerned citizen sermon. Huh. What does that one say? Don't think it really matters anymore since I killed the guy. Got three copies of him, apparently. Remember, dear people, that a fire once lit cannot be stopped. Blah, 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 blah. I'm gonna kill you. Burn in the eternal fire. Have a good day.
Hey, grey hair!
And you're a fine fella for not ratting me out. Prepared to give you a discount for that, mate. So, shall we trade?
Yeah, let's. Hopefully no interruptions this time.
See if he's got anything special. Anything I need? Nothing pops out at me. I can brew Dwarven Spirit like I need to? Don't I have like 50 million Dwarven Spirits? I swear I find them everywhere. Hydranium. Don't know if that matters. Sure, I'll take it. Lesser Glyph of Infusion. Eh, that's fine. Nothing too special that I want. Okay, right. To the... Whoops. Didn't mean to use a potion there. To the main quest. Not the main quest of the game, but the main quest that I want to do. So here's what I want to do. So I'm going for a light character build that uses light armor, tries to get behind opponents, does critical hit damage, and is kind of fast, basically. Like a ninja. I want to be like a ninja, basically. So, what I'm going to do is a treasure hunt that I started a long time ago, but was too low level to do. Cat school gear. Yep, apparently there's 7 diagrams. It's level 17, I'm level 18, so I should be able to use all the gear. And it is... all the diagrams are in the passages under Temple Isle. Which, evidently... is right here. So it looks like it's maybe on the coast, so I think I'm going to take a boat. Did Geralt hurt himself getting away from the dock? It's been a while since I've been sailing. So beautiful. Ooh, is that a chest? Yes, it is. Doppler decoction. I've never even made a single decoction. I forgot what they even are. I was thinking that it might be like a cave system around here, because it said explore the passages. I was thinking you can get there using the boat. Looks like, yeah, there's an entrance to like a cave right up there, but how do I actually get up there? It's awfully high. Maybe I'm going about this the wrong way. How would I get up there? Could I crawl my way up there? Using various ledges? You know what? I actually just might be able to. This is probably gonna end in disaster, but let's give it a shot. That's a bit high up. This is not gonna work, is it? No. And these textures are so blurry that I feel like you're not even supposed to be here. No, this is not the way you're supposed to do it. Go further around, see if we can find another way up. I could, of course, just go up there normally. But I feel like there should be a back entrance to it. I mean, if we did come from above, I guess we'd have to drop down to that little cave entrance there. You'd have to drop down pretty far, though. So I really don't know exactly how you're intended to get there. Yes, yes, blub, 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 you want to kill me. Cool, cool. You really just can't get there from the back, can you? I really want to make this work. I feel like there's a way to make this work. Also, the front left of my boat is falling apart. I'm gonna mess around with this for a bit. I'll be right back. My boat just sank. Well, I managed to get where no person is ever meant to go. You can tell because things don't look right. They really don't look right. And I think that right over there is the pathway that would take me to the cave, I think. But unfortunately, it's out of reach. Just not gonna work. Let's slide down. Whee! Go back in the water. Try again. Oh, I died. Wait, I died, but I didn't. Interesting. Interesting. Perhaps I become a vampire. I'm undead. Let's try to get up there like a kind of normal person.
Back there at Loch Moraine.
There should be a way down to the passages. Just gotta look for a good place to drop down.
Gonna be sick.
Oh, I've gotta go around to get up.
Got right cabbage last night.
This place is very vertical. I've also never been here before, so it's pretty cool.
Move on.
I must resolve matters quickly and leave.
Oh wait, no, I have been here before. This is where I escaped with Ciri. With the whole dandelion thing. Right. Okay, now I just need to get down. Yeah, I'm sure it's safe. It wasn't safe. I know there's a way down there. There's gotta be. Unless there's another entrance to the passages. Whoa. Yeah, so I need to get directly beneath me. It's way too far of a drop. Oh, it's a bit lower here. There's no way this is low enough, though. Oh, Jesus. Ooh. Ooh, there, that's how you get there. There we go. Aha. And we have found the passages under Temple Isle. Well, I think this is a pretty good place to end the episode. So, I hope you've enjoyed so far, and when I return, we are going to check out the passages under Temple Isle and get the Cat School gear and then craft it.